those pesky potholes, they are a symptom of winter weather as unavoidable as the flu.
My current level of stress is tilt rotor pilot flying the Osprey. It's both a plane and it's a helicopter. It's called a tilt rotor because it has two nacelles, which it has our engines and our transmissions are actually mounted on the outside of the wing. And you have the ability to move that from the down position, which is an airplane, or you can move them up if you fly like a helicopter. You have to think as an airplane pilot sometimes, and other times when you go to land or you get low, you have to think as a helicopter pilot. So you're incorporating all aspects of aviation into one airframe. Our day-to-day life as an Osprey pilot, come in early in the morning, you're usually planning for a couple hours, coordinating with whatever ground unit you're going to go fly with that day. You do a pre-flight inspection on the aircraft, the walk around, and you get in, you start up the aircraft, and start executing the mission, whatever it is that day. So we'll take off as 2, 3, 4 aircraft, and fly somewhere, pick up troops, and some of it's timed. So you have to get them in at a certain time, at a certain place. So that's where a lot of the planning comes in. We can do that both on the ground, and if the mission changes, we can do a lot of that in the air, in the aircraft. The way we use the Osprey tactically is you can use it in two different ways. You can take advantage of the airplane aspect of it, and you can fly high. So we can climb really high, and we'll have the landing zone marked out on our global position system. And basically, when we get over it, we do a spiral dive. And then as we're coming down in the turn, and we're spiraling towards the ground, we actually convert into a helicopter, slow the aircraft down, and land. The second option is, we'll fly as an airplane, but we'll go really low. We'll just be about 200 feet, literally at 220 knots, about 250 miles per hour. Once again, convert into a helicopter and land into the landing zone. As long as we can physically fit the aircraft, we can go there. And because it's so powerful, we can carry 24 troops in the back, and it can be fully combat loaded. And so we can be a fairly heavy platform. So we have the aspects of both.